So trust us, we're not fishing for the dough to fund our vision. The provisions we envision have long been preordained. Just as we foresaw it, you reached into your wallet and you gave. Your cash well must manifest the grandest end result. Legally, we have to say that this is not a cult.
Totally not a cult.
And soon the whole wide world will be enlightened.
Hey!
Wait, I want
all to. Right.
We did it!
Yes!
Yes!
Yes! Very good.
Yes.
Well, how do I make balloons? This is confetti.
Dang.
Do I do this for balloons?
You get in a sewer, and you creep on children.
Beautiful.
Oh, okay, cool.
Hey, everybody.
Hey, what a special thing to be able to watch that clip of that song and then come out of it right here with the composer lyricists themselves.
Wow.
And immediately
Angela and Allie.
What were you thinking?
Yeah. Yeah. This is actually a drill session. This is a red table talk.
What the hell were you thinking with that?
Intervention.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello, everyone at home. If you've been here for the last month, thank you for being here and joining us for this very final Thursday debate stream. If this is your first stream with us, where the hell have you been? But we're glad you're here now. We're joined by Allie Gordon and Angela Parrish, who, as I alluded to, are our lovely songwriters. And we're really excited to have you here to fight about shit.
Yeah.
It's going to be great. All right.
Angela's
just to answer
nervous.
Some questions off the back.
Very nervous.
Christina Joy, I am eating a pupusa.
Mm.
You know,
where
they're from Costco. They're from Costco.
Okay.
They're like a little. They're like I just put them in the air fryer, and just
I love pupusas. Awesome.
With
fun
a little
to
bit
say,
of
fun to eat.
Fun to say, fun to eat. Got a little bit of guac.
Sounds great.
I love guac.
It's great.
Wait, is it Trader Joe's?
A Costco.
Oh,
wow.
Better.
I like how you tried to force that in there, though. You said Trader Joe's, right?
You said
Trader Joe's,
right?
I get paid every time you say Trader Joe's, so I just want to make sure that you say
you
Trader Joe's.
You said Trader Joe's, correct?
Right? Yeah,
Jane's? What is it called? Can somebody just say it?
We should probably check back in with your royalty pool. You know, in our very first stream, we discovered that you make so much money every time we play these clips and these sound effects. And, you know, what's your total at right now?
I think I'm at 200,000.
That's unbelievable.
So I'm just really hoping you hit the end of the stream and then you can just pass it all over. So
it's going to be really satisfying for you to just go right from finishing the live streams with us to getting paid from all of the live streams.
Yeah, thank you so much. And I just want to say I really appreciate just that, you know, some creators won't talk about money. Do you know what I'm saying? And here we are just talking about how much money you're going to hand over to me the minute that this is done. I just want to say I really appreciate that. I really feel...
You got it.
I suppose we're taken care of.
Mm-hmm. You got it.
Can I get that delivered via a big check?
It'll be a big, it'll be a big check and it'll be delivered by Ronald McDonald.
I was going to say Regis Philbin.
One and the same.
He ain't around.
They're both dead, aren't they?
So it'd actually be dead. So.
Ronald McDonald also severely
Ronald
dead.
Also dead. Yeah.
Famously dead.
Yeah.
Let's look at some... Wait, Psych. Real quick. Molly Rice said, Angela's looking like an angle right now.
a cute one.
Oh!
Math jokes is so nice.
It was a typo, but Allie managed to spin that into gold.
Oh. I just did every movement in the book trying to see if a reaction would happen. And none did.
I thought maybe it was a new Gen Z thing. Like, you look like an angle. Like, I don't know.
That's
like
what I
angle.
Thought, too.
Yeah. an angle.
What a cute, that's you know, that's unbelievable.
But I do love the setup, Angela. It's like, I don't know what Mr. Megorium's Wonder Emporium is, but it's giving me those vibes.
Cute.
You know, it just seems like there's so many fun doodads and zip doodles and instruments around.
There are so
many. I have a lot of zip doodles in here. This is my studio where I make the stupidest things known to person kind. And this, it's designed, it's optimized for ADHD chaos. And it's, it's a lot of fun. There's a couch, and Allie's butt has been on the couch. We wrote one of our songs together when I was on tonsil removal drugs.
I love that. Yeah. What I love is that Angela's like, I don't really remember writing it, but the song does. Song does go hard for a song that you don't remember writing.
I have very little memory.
You channeled it though. You channeled it from the great beyond.
I was like, well, you're here. We should write while you're here. And then, because we had stuff to do. And then I was like, I'm also having my tonsils out, but I'll probably be fine. I was not fine, but I wasn't that bad. I don't know. I don't remember.
When you were like awake, everything you said and did made perfect sense.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's good. Oh, you know, the screenshots I sent my husband the day of the surgery did not make sense.
And we're going to see those a little bit later. We're going to throw on the
and at 265,000, we are going to publicly post those as well as Angela's address, social security number, all the info you need.
Because friends, we are here to make money. We are raising money for our 10-year anniversary season, which, you know, we're close. We are close.
We are very close. It is, it's thrilling for everyone out there who has been nonstop promoting and up in their pledges and sharing and everything. Thank you so much. It is like, you know, it was Brian, I feel like we're talking about it now. It was dark for a while there. I think there were times when we were like, this is going to be rough. It was, but
you all made it a lot better. You know,
made it a lot better. You all made it a lot better. It's like hanging out with everyone here and just like, it's very, very, very nice. And truly it is like a immense relief. We were just talking about what our plans are going to be on Sunday once it's all done and we can kind of like relax for a little bit. And you know, Brian and I are seeing Dune. So that's one way to celebrate everything wrapping up. Yeah. What else could we do?
What else could you do?
Yeah.
Good. Good. I'm working on pulling up a graphic of this season so we can talk about it a little bit.
And I will be releasing a video of Diane's fashion show soon, this is one of the outfits. And she's in these little donut PJs.
And they're so perfect.
She's got they're like assless chaps.
They're assless.
Zappa has some of those too.
Angela also has a famously cute dog. I feel like we get another $10,000 out of this.
Ooh. Yeah.
I might go grab Frank Zappa.
Go get Frank Zappa.
And while you're grabbing the Frank Zappa, we're gonna talk about some fun things
we're gonna Zappa you all the way.
Yeah, I don't know how to get the backgrounds are mixed up, but it's okay. I like it. Beautiful.
There you go.
You got it.
Friends, if we get to $200,000 by 4 p.m. this Saturday after a 10-hour stream, which is just going to absolutely wreck us, we'll be going to Edinburgh Fringe Festival. Zappa, what do you think about that?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Let's bring him up here.
One of my own
16-year-old dog. He is such a good boy.
Oh my gosh.
Allie's is like best friend in the whole world.
I took him on a walk and now we are bonded for life.
Oh. Ooh, did you barf? Oh boy, maybe. I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know. Here's what you do. So he got a little farm animal scarf on.
Okay.
He has three kinds of cancer and he doesn't care. He doesn't really know. He doesn't seem to really be that affected by it, to tell you the truth.
That's the best.
He's an angle.
He is an angle and he still has lots of energy, even though you can't tell right now. I've had him.
Puppy.
Well, I've had him since I was in like a junior in college.
Oh,
wow. Oh, Bubba.
What a good boy. Companion.
It's true.
He smells so bad.
I was told he's able to open any zipper.
He can. So he is so smart. I taught him, he can learn. He's like literally can learn any new trick that I teach him for the most part. And he loves granola bars. And so my husband's a trumpet player. And when, oh, thank you, buddy. When, so he puts snack, and also he also has diabetes, and he like has to put just snacks in his trumpet case and things because, you know, that's what you do when you're diabetic. And Zap has learned how to unzip his trumpet case with his teeth and get the granola bars out of the trumpet case. It's madness. He found Zap a box of Fiber One bars once and ate the whole box and shit himself to the moon.
Yeah.
To the moon.
he was, yeah. But he's like, this is you guys leave these things for me to find. That's why you do it, right? You want me to find it. Then he's like, I did it. Aren't you proud of me? And then he shits for a week, and then he's not so happy. But
I'm proud of you. Yeah. I'm proud of you, Frank Zappa. I love you.
Love you.
Shit himself to the moon. Yep.
Straight to the moon, Alice.
Yeah, he's seeing Rocket Man.
Oh, holy moly. Did you get a haircut?
No.
Are you bored?
Don't sing that, otherwise we have to play Pay RuPaul.
You're paying me actually $100,000. Did you get a haircut, Corey?
No.
What's looking so curly today?
Why it's not do you think as he wet was late? Those hair curlers, he's not getting on the stream with those hair curlers in.
It's not as wet. It's a little more like floof.
Yeah.
Why do we say wet? Wet feels suspicious.
I feel like last time I saw it, it was like it had like it looked like you had just showered, or maybe had put something in it that was.
Yeah,
that was
I mean, damp. it's got like the little like it's like it. There's more definition and less.
More volume. There's volume.
Yeah.
There is volume. Yeah. I brought it up because I like it. Is what I just want to say. Like, I didn't bring it up to like.
Regardless, like however it looks, it's always natural, and I always woke up like that.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, and as compelling is, guys, we have only 48 hours to raise the money to fund our Tinlightenment World Tour. We're going to Edinburgh with your help. We're making a new show with Ali and Angela called Gross Profits. It's going to be in LA. It's going to be in Australia. We're doing a new pilot we're doing a reading of a new pilot that eventually will hopefully be that a much new more. Pilot called Intelligent Life. We're going to New York where this could be on Broadway in concert at 54 Below, just mere feet from Broadway. We're doing a live concert screening in April of Spy Another Day with this all-star cast. We're also doing a screening in London, England. Ever heard of it? And then we also are doing no less than 3 great debates with different casts throughout the year, which is a new live comedy game show. So what do you say?
We got a lot of good stuff. And speaking of great debate, I think we maybe should get debating
our
first debate.
Give the people what they want.
Give the people what they want.
After our first debate, maybe we'll do a few shout outs. Remember, if you have been on here and you have been since we started about 20 minutes ago, if you're either becoming a new backer, which we have 2,407, which is only what amount away from how many? Okay. So we are only 67 backers away from how many backers we had for Wayward Guide, which was the most amount of backers.
Wow. Of course.
Oh, cool.
A holy number.
Which is a holy number. There we go. Ooh, oh my gosh, beautiful. We just jumped up again.
Look at that.
So if you are one of the new backers, if you are one of the 67 people that get us to our backer ceiling and then blast through that backer ceiling, or
if you shit yourself to the moon through the ceiling.
If you shit yourself to the moon through the ceiling or up $10 during the stream, you know, you get a little shout out.
Someone just shat themselves to the moon.
Shit themselves to the moon, you know? We just unlock this? We just unlocked the Dan social takeover.
Oh, wow.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
What has to be wrought?
No. He is going to be a weird man on this, no, which is good.
Wonderful.
Which is very good.
If you're like, who what knows are we when talking that day will about? Come?
It'll happen, but when it happens, you'll just know. You'll know there'll be something off about what's being posted. There'll be a lot of weird jokes. We're going to be, our socials will all be talking about some weird streaming services that don't exist. Mm. It'll be weird.
Yeah, if you don't know what we're talking about, go to our Instagram, Tin Can Bros, to see the most updated list of milestones, which we're unlocking at every $2,500 on the way to Tin Enlightenment.
And we're quite close to, we're so close, we're only $2,000 away from 190, which is so nice, which is 95% funded.
Yeah.
And it's like, you know, obviously I want to like, you know, we want to hit the goal as soon as possible, but it would be fun to do it on a live stream at some point. You know, it would be fun to be there. It would be fun to get it live.
I would love to hit 190 today because it just feels so right.
It would. But I also just want to say hitting it on a live stream is second priority to just hitting it as fast as possible and just shooting right by it to 250K.
Shooting right by it.
You know, we've got a couple days. We've got 48 hours.
We've got a couple days.
Yeah.
Just one couple of a day.
Got about 48 hours until the end, but 38 hours until the start of the live stream. Is that right? Yeah. 39 hours.
You're going to have to pay me more to do math.
Yeah, and if someone at home wants to do a supercut of Joey just doing math in all the live streams over the last month, just go.
We'll put it as a reel. We'll do it as a reel.
We'll
post
that.
It'll be a reel on our channel, and you'll be credited.
Before we get Great Debate, and I just want to answer this question from Storm really quick, which is the Great Debate going to be on YouTube/Digital Ticket? And Storm, all the projects, most of the projects are going to be on Digital Ticket. This year, and Great Debate is going to be on YouTube, as well as Gross Profits will eventually also be on YouTube for free. And if you check the Kickstarter page, you can read all about how you can watch each of the projects this season. But there it is.
And we
That's
are
exciting.
And you we are past 188. My God, my God, my God.
So
we
exciting.
Are very, very exciting. And you know, if you're like, why am I only my pledge at this point?
So excited.
Am I only up in my pledges point for shout outs? You don't need to. We got all sorts of fun add-ons that we've been adding on the last couple of days.
That's right. In fact, just this morning, we released a few more, which we're very excited about. So check out the most recent Kickstarter update and the Kickstarter page for info on that. Yes. And maybe later we'll even preview them on the live stream.
Whoa.
I just updated the deck.
Oh,
what does that mean? The deck.
What does that mean? I don't know.
Which deck?
The slides that you were just showing earlier.
Oh, okay.
The deck.
Yeah. All right, people.
Okay. Oh, the deck.
Yeah.
To the deck.
This is some great stuff. This.
That's nothing new.
This is not new, but this is a shirt that you could be enjoying.
Yeah, Roku I love shirt. The one that looks like the 90s wrestling shirt.
That's
big.
Yeah,
I love it.
I'm feeling good in what I wear, you know.
But yeah, here actually, let me just jump in here.
Did anybody else not have cable? So you watched
I also did
WWF. Not have cable. I watched a lot of PBS and wrestling and American.
Yeah,
I love a back-to-back of like Finding Your Roots just right up against like Stone Cold Steve Austin fighting the Undertaker or something.
That's exactly right.
That's it.
I just breathe.
This long sleeve shirt is a new shirt that was just added.
Yeah, featuring our famous TCB mascot that you've known and loved for the last 10 years.
That is
Can awesome. Dude.
Oh, it's Canny.
It's the can dude.
Sorry, I had the VHS, the off-brand VHS of this that was made in the country.
Yeah.
They translated. We called him Canny.
I'm just imagining this guy like... everywhere he goes, just going, sure, can do, fella. Yeah.
Doesn't he look like a little Cuphead character?
Yeah, he's yes. fun. I like him a lot.
He looks like he's in Cuphead.
So cute.
I like him a lot.
I like him a lot.
Yeah. We'll have to name him at some point.
Yeah. Maybe.
Can dude. Yeah.
Can dude.
Can dude.
Oh,
Danny, you. Tinifer.
You don't, Alexandra, because you maybe need to go look back into all the things. He's there.
Oh, yeah.
And has always been there.
Always.
And the first person that finds him in our past videos will give you all the money.
He's really famous.
He's so famous.
He's a really famous character.
I'm amazed that he signed on for your campaign. That's like really
pretty
cool.
I know. This is pretty cool.
Yeah. Well,
is the mustache and the eyebrows the only body hair he's able to grow?
Whoa, good question.
He has hair inside the can.
Yeah.
Oh god.
The inside of the can
inside
is
inside and also the bottom.
Yeah, like one of those weird messed up tumors that your bodies grow that have like teeth and hair inside.
Uh-huh. That's like a twin. He's got another can. Did you he ate another can in the womb.
You'll remember in the animated adventures of this can, that one episode where it got the can opener right in the head and the hair all poofed out because it was so pressurized.
I do remember that, actually. That was the season finale. That was a cliffhanger.
It was a huge cliffhanger. And then the show is not picked up for more episodes. So we live in that cliffhanger forever.
Very good. Well.
But yeah, so anyway, we got the nice like long sleeve. Our little can dude. A little can dude pin. So like also if you get three pins, you get the fourth one for free.
Whoa.
Then we've got like a nice poster.
Totally not a cult.
I know. That makes me so happy though. That has made it on two merch. That makes me feel
two merch.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we got a them magnet. We've got this like stained glass poster, totally not a cult hat.
Hilarious.
Fridge magnet. We got the stickers.
Stickies.
This is like a big this like stained glass window one is like a big sticky, so you can stick it on your own candle and make a little prayer candle for your tinctuary or brothedral.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Mm.
We don't want to ship an actual prayer candle. That seems hard.
No.
And then some buttons for your ass.
Yeah, these are going to go right in your ass.
Oh my god. All three of these easily.
It's a bundle.
These are great. Yeah, these are a bundle, but they're also if you take a look, these are some fun little jokes from the campaign memories of this month.
Memories.
Yeah. I remember that. An inside joke is really one of the most powerful things.
Isn't it?
That binds people together.
Speaking of, I drove past that Mount Everest billboard again.
Oh.
But this time in Hollywood, I had driven past it like on the one, mm-hmm. or like the 110 or something. There are two of them in LA every time.
Wow.
Yeah.
Incredible.
Who knows? Maybe we'll get to, we got to show that.
The
billboard?
But yeah, anyway, these buttons.
We'll take you in a car personally and drive you past the billboard on the 110.
But in case you can't read on the stream, like the buttons say, my ass and bio, holy yacht, and we need the rich gaze. But they're like subtle enough where I think you could just wear them out and about. Where like,
They got little fun images on them. Yeah, it's great. These are great.
I love
These are if you're into enlightenment, it's like game recognized game. If you see someone walk by with their bag and you just catch a little glimpse of a little, you know, tin light and pyramid pin, and you go, I see you.
You know,
brother.
Do you have like a motion? Do you know what I'm saying?
Is there
a silent acknowledgement you can give to somebody else who's too enlightened?
Well, you can do the tin can triangle, which is forehead, left nipple, right nipple, very hands to the heart.
Yeah. Okay. I will do that. If I ever see someone out with one of these pins out, I will do that.
Good. Very good. Perfect. Shall we get debating?
We must.
Yeah.
We can't have too much fun with the merch. We must also have rage.
I love that.
I'm so scared.
I am too.
I feel like Allie is very prepared and I am very not.
Well, I have something to present before we get into debating.
Okay.
Not necessarily tech, but just I want to illuminate you as to my approach today.
You want to eliminate us?
I want to eliminate you from the chat. So here's the deal. I love debating and I love arguing and I love being right. And I have been watching your great debate streams because I have been studying, because you emailed early on being like, we'd love for you guys to do a great debate.
Jesus Christ.
I was like, that's amazing. If I lose, I'll jump out a window. So I was like, I need to make sure that I can't possibly make that be a possibility. So I have been watching. I've watched things that were previously uploaded. I've been seeing what people respond to. And I have also noticed a trend. One thing is that a lot of people come here to have fun. And I understand the impetus, but no one ever said this was about having fun. Right? No, nobody was ever like, the person who has the most fun wins the debate. So I was like, okay, let's make sure we're not doing that. The other thing is that I've noticed that people, they'll get into the weeds about like the thing they're debating against. But when you think about the most famous debates, which are like political ones, what do people attack? Not just their points, but their character. So I just want you to know I have come fully prepared today to do some muckraking and mudslinging. I will be Jesus making Christ. Sure that you cannot amass votes. So I'm
you know
really
we're
forward.
Working. You know we're all working together after this if we hit our goal, right?
Absolutely.
Allegedly.
Do you see on Twitter the Willy Wonka experience that they did in Moscow?
Have you seen our memes?
What did that experience realize they were lacking from the narrative? A villain. So they created the unknown and they put him behind a mirror. And her. I feel your franchise has been lacking a villain. And so her. I would like to
Did you
present...
see that the actor actually came out publicly and made a statement?
Whoa, no. That's so exciting.
We'll talk about it offline, but please.
They will talk about it offline. So I just want to say wrestling is a perfect way to get into this. You have had no heel. And I feel that your franchise is suffering. Mm. So I'm here today to present myself as a villain. And I'm really excited about it.
Okay.
I love a villain that recognizes that they are a villain.
Sorry, that's my ride. Huh?
That's my ride, the cops.
That's my ride.
Do you have something to share as well? Or is that
I will. I certainly will, depending on who I'm going up against. I also just want to say for the record, sorry, that is so loud. My friends are here. for the record, Angela, I have nothing against you. I didn't make a single thing. I couldn't possibly say a negative thing against Angela. Angela is an angel. Angela is too good for this world. Most of our conversations go like this. Angela goes, somebody was mean at work to me today. What should I do? And I say, don't worry about it. I've already sent a box of live locusts to their house. You don't have to think about this ever again.
I just realized how many times I've told you this.
But it's always like, it's the same conversation. You're always just like, I don't really know why I let that person talk to me that way. And I'm like, I actually don't think they ever will again. Wink. And you're like, what does that mean? I'm like, don't worry about it.
Oh my God. Oh, that's so sweet. Bye. I love you. I'm really excited to be impressed by, well, I'm always impressed by you, but like, I'm just going to sit back and let you dominate. This is going to be so great. And no one could ever insult me as much as I do to myself daily, constantly. So I'm
if we want to just get started and just on the right mindset, I sent you a video that's called Group.
Yeah.
Okay.
Would you play that?
Yeah, sure. I got it queued up.
Just pull up.
Here we go.
Sure.
This is a video called but you mean TCB1?
TCB. Yeah, sorry.
Okay.
That's the group one. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh boy.
This is I want you to understand, like, this is the group. This is the TCB.
Yeah,
this
yeah,
is what
yeah.
Stand for, do you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Okay.
Let's do it. wait.
We got to play this.
Do you have it? Or do you want me to do it?
You just told me my video was too short.
Too short?
Oh, wait. Are you presenting or?
Excuse me? let me try
if none of my tech works, I'll be scared.
Your video is a bit too short.
Oh god. What? They're all short.
I don't know. I've never gotten that before.
What? Hold on. You want here, let me see if I can
edit them all together into one big mega cut. Here, let me they are short. They're a little
bit. Yeah, it's in a folder labeled Alley Ammunition.
Yeah. I didn't even make that. I love that.
let me try see if this works.
Okay.
Right after the break, we're going to interview Eric Wyhamayo, who climbed the highest mountain in the world, Mount Everest.
But I didn't do this.
He's gay. Excuse me. He's blind. So we'll hear about that coming
up. Okay. As we head to
the
break,
6:00. Allie.
I didn't do this. This is all Corey.
Still my favorite.
Okay, so we don't have it.
Here, what I know what we'll do.
We're working on it.
I can quickly go throw everything into one.
No. No, no, no.
Allie, is it really where in live stream assets, Bri?
Oh yeah.
I didn't know.
I'm just gonna screen share it.
This feels genuinely villainous now because I've just been making this go badly. So I'm sorry.
Oh god. Oh no. Okay. That's my face. Okay, let's see. Present. Screen? Window.
And then we must debate.
And then we must For debate. Real. Yeah, here we go. Here's one.
Oh boy.
No, wait, that's Yeah.
Is that the one?
This is the DCB one.
This is about your group ethos.
This is okay. From the Choose Our Destiny rewatch.
This is 1 second long. This is You'll 1 second long.
How? Okay, let's see.
We have no.
Wow.
We have no what?
Wait, play it again.
We have no.
We have no.
Wow.
We have no girl.
We have no girl. And you know what? Now that I think about that, that's true.
But we have no.
You mean in our group, Tin Cam Bros?
Wait, play it one more time. Just like okay. We have no.
We have no. Girl.
We have
I
no.
Guess that's true. I guess girl. Don't have we a no girl. Girl.
Okay, now I'm not confused at all why the program went. This video
was like,
not a
this
video.
Is too this short.
Yeah, that makes sense. That actually checks out.
Don't worry about that.
Oh my God.
Okay, so you send us GIFs.
Yeah, basically. Don't worry. They all have sound. It's These pretty are... interesting, though, that they would get on a live stream and brag about that.
Yeah, that is really weird that is actual footage that we made.
Yeah.
It's actually kind of fucked up.
It is factual.
Okay. I mean, so for the first debate, it will be myself, Angela, Allie, and Corey. Is that correct?
Oh, that's
debating.
Great.
So is there any other clip that we want to play before we get debating, or do we want to save these
why,
for
can
later?
I do it as a rebuttal to your to whatever you say?
Yeah.
Sure.
Can you go first? Okay, great. Sure.
Sure. I think and if the other clips are longer than less than 1 second, I think we'll have no problem playing them.
Yeah, they might be. Normal. I hope okay. they are. I think they are.
It's really funny.
Yeah, that's right. Corey hasn't aged a day since that video, which was recorded last Friday. Beautiful.
I feel like you're saying that I look tired and old, which not no.
Not no.
Corey has excellent, excellent skin and a beautiful skincare routine.
Okay,
school.
Friends. So,
who's going first?
We're doing it. So, what is the first category? The first category, I believe, is the coolest thing to say on your deathbed.
It sure is.
So, it's pretty good. So, you at home, get ready for we're doing it.
And maybe a TCB, then Angela and Allie, then another TCB.
Yeah.
A big lightning bolt halfway down the middle. Like
I'm ready
Brothers.
To go.
Hell yeah.
Beautiful. It's you. Where's it? There we go.
Okay. So the coolest thing to say on your deathbed is something that I learned in a little piece of media called Lost. And that is the phrase, see you in another life, brother. Which is just the fucking coolest thing to say before, you know, absolutely being blown to smithereens. Because A, it like implies like a little just like chillness, even though you're about to like perish into like the mysterious afterlife and you don't know what's going to happen. But by calling someone brother, it's just so like, I don't know. It's just, to me, it feels like it's a very laid back thing to say, just like, hey, see you in another life, brother. It also presupposes that there is another life, which is just like really fucking cool to have that kind of confidence, you know, moments before meeting your demise, just to be like, you know, I'm confident, I'm relaxed, I'll see you in the next one. Peace out. Okay.
Very good.
I think that was really good. Okay. I will say though,
You actually legally have to save it.
I
thought you said you watched these before.
No, you're so right. I just got excited. I'm so sorry.
Okay. And next up we have Angela.
Okay. Well, So I feel like the coolest thing you could say on your deathbed is, I hope you find where I buried it, and then just peace out. So many great things about this. It allows you to potentially fuck with your entire family for years beyond your death. It's like a way of achieving immortality. You're going to just create so much chaos and confusion. Are they going to be like, what was it? Was it treasure? Mm. Was it a body? Was it even real? You know, the best thing you can do as a legacy is confuse and disturb people. And I think that there's nothing that says love and commitment more than just total, complete, and utter chaos. And so it's also funny. And like, why not go out with a sense of humor? So I hope you find where I buried it. That be all.
That be all, folks.
Very good. Very good. Next up, we have Allie Gordon.
Oh my God, that was fun.
Oh, celebrating early, are we?
Okay, so I think that the coolest words that you can say as your final words on your deathbed are look behind you. I think Angela and I are coming from a similar point of view here, which is that to leave someone with such a moment of confusion really is a power move. But I also feel that it has a dual purpose here. If you have family members who you love, who love you, who you have a good relationship with, when they think about your last words, they'll smile because they'll think, there they are behind me forever, supporting me, their hand on my shoulder. But if you have enemies and your last words are look behind you, forevermore they will feel the specter of your last words behind them. They will be tiptoeing around every corner, paranoid at every interaction, afraid of every noise in the dark. And so I feel that it does, it both extends a loving hand to those who are your friends and an evil hand to your enemies.
Well done.
Very, very good. Very, very special. and spooky, some would say. And finally, we have Corey Lubowitz.
Thank you so much for having me. With respect to all the other panelists, the question here is not what would be interesting and intriguing, but what is the coolest thing to say? And at the end of the day, being cool is about drawing people in, about them wanting more. And honestly, trying hard is not cool. So I think the coolest thing you can say is nothing at all. Just like, leave them wanting more. Like, act like you're about to say something and ghost. Just like, get out of there. Don't say anything at all. That's like the fucking coolest thing you could do. You go, man, like you have them leaning in. You're not exerting effort. Like, you make them come to you. And like, that's cool. Cool isn't trying. Cool is being laid back. And yeah, I don't know. I yield my time.
Wow. That was a really cool way to end.
Actually, that was really cool. Dad. Yielding time is like really cool.
Okay. And now, with 5 minutes on the clock, y'all have at it.
All right. I mean, major, major notes. First, let's talk about, as Corey was saying, like what the category is. The category is the coolest thing to say on your deathbed. And yeah, cool. Being cool is about being calm, being collected, being like laid back, easygoing, which Ali and Angela, to me, like creating chaos and kind of just like trolling someone on the way out is not cool. It's not like in the spirit of cool.
Okay.
Know?
Yeah.
I'd argue it's quirky.
I received, I just want you to know, I received that. I received that information. But I do want to say it's just so funny coming from you, because I don't think of you as, I don't think you can be seen as being trustworthy. If we want to go to the tapes, if we want to pause the clock.
Which one? Brian one or two?
Give me Brian one, because we'll follow it up with Brian too.
Do we have to pause the timer?
Nah,
these are short. They're short.
Nah.
Right.
Maybe somebody can rebut while we're pulling them up.
Yeah. While you're pulling it up, I just want to say that, Corey, while I appreciate where you're coming from in terms of like the actual coolness, you're kind of like
anyone in the room with you, get them over to the computer right now. Ali and Angela.
Oh no, the video didn't play.
Oh wait, did you not see it?
No, but I heard it.
Oh, okay. Let me try again.
It sounds to me like hidden footage, hidden tape footage that was probably taken without my consent.
Well, you still said it. Okay, so let's hit this one.
If there's anyone in the room with you, get them over to the computer right now. Ali and Angela.
What? Were you trying to incite violence against two women before the stream even started?
Anyone in the room with you, get them over to the computer right now. Ali and Angela.
That is so messed up. Hopefully it doesn't escalate any more than that, and it ends at hitting women. Is there another tape? Can you play Brian too?
Oh my god.
Oh god.
Can I just play Brian too?
Can you play Brian too?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
I did say that, didn't I?
Yeah, it's weird. You did say that.
We've got to hit
the Department of Homeland Security. Wow.
We've got to hit Department of Homeland Security.
Wait, whoa. I'm sorry. This
Brian, that is so messed up. That we should call the cops, honestly. Like, that's
maybe,
so messed up.
But it's
you.
Not against the bylaws of what this debate is, because this debate is not about domestic terrorism, you know. It's about what is the coolest thing to say on the deathbed. And Corey, nothing at all is not a thing to say. You can't say nothing at all. It's a contradictory.
You just used
statement.
It in a sentence. That sounded right to me.
No, it's like it's an oxymoron. It does not. Okay, if we're talking about the coolest thing to say, just casually and calmly, as you're about to be detonated by a bomb, maybe just
yeah.
say,
"Sounds like a
see
threat.
In another life, brother." You know, now, I'm cool. I'm collected.
A nice topical reference, a current pop culture reference.
Okay, it is in that.
I think that Corey is on to something with being like withholding. Now, deathbed is the only place where it doesn't work to me, because I would just assume that person died and that they were not withholding something from me, like in a cool or purposeful way. I would just be like, oh, shit, they had something to say and they didn't make it.
Exactly.
So I would never be like, holy God, that was so cool.
That was cool.
Not say that. Yeah, I'd be like, damn, Corey didn't manage to
exactly.
say that.
Exactly. How could you even understand the intention? That's a really good point, Ali.
I'm not in your brain. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Mm. It's called... physical cues. It's called facial expression. We say things without saying things, you know?
We communicate, we gesture, but I think if you look at the definition of say, I don't think we say it.
But the criticism was that, like, you wouldn't know that, like, I was being withholding. But I think you could. Context clues.
Okay.
And just to circle back around again to Angela and Ali, because yours are very similar. They're both just like freaking pranking people on the way out. Like Corey said, like quirky, yes. Like, might you crack someone up, and might that be like endearing if that's their sense of humor?
It's like yes. That's like the plot of like a fun indie movie starring Zooey Deschanel.
Sure, yes. But can your last words both inspire fear and a sense of love and togetherness even after you're gone? That's
yes. that cool?
Cool. Yes, but is that cool?
Do you know what's cool? $1 billion. I think the coolest thing of all is everybody choosing their own definition of cool.
Whoa. Ending on kind of some niceties. Okay. I am going to drop a poll into the chat. So I'm starting the poll currently right now so you can vote on the four answers people gave. The first quote, "See you in another life, brother. I hope you find where I buried it. Look behind you and nothing."
For the coolest thing to say on your deathbed.
The coolest thing.
And they're going. And as we are kind of waiting for those results to come in, maybe we should do some shout outs. Maybe we should do some shout outs. And
we should probably do our coolest versions of shout outs.
Ooh. Yeah. Should we like dab on them or something?
Is that
cool?
I
think you should
this one?
Sing them while doing like a jazz version of
Yeah. So like snapping?
Yeah.
Nikki and Madison Opal Hurst. No, that's where. Cool. Should we do that like that?
Yeah, I'm just waiting for my thing to catch up.
Okay. So we're starting at Madison. At how many minutes ago? Let's see.
Can I do sax saxo?
43 minutes ago.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, this is great. Okay.
And this OBS background is cool.
Oh, no.
Okay, sweet.
That is cool.
Uh-oh.
I pressed the wrong button. Shut up.
Listen, no background. You know what's cool? No background.
Okay.
Madison.
There we go.
Thank you.
Very
Madison.
Good. Opal Hurst, thank you for doing this.
Skyla. Increase their pledge. Thank you, Skyla.
Ren from Mars, we're happy to have you here.
As well as Bridget McArdle, thank you for increasing your pledge.
And Bryn Landis, I hope you enjoy your add-ons.
Cassie increased their pledge as well.
Bailey, so much so did it that we are on here yelling their name.
Ellis. Yachtson increased their pledge. Holy Yachtson.
Gabby Knapp, thank you for doing this. We love you, Gabby.
Christina Joy increased their pledge. Thank you, Christina Joy.
Thank you, Lynn. We love having you here.
Julia Whalen increased their pledge. Thank you, Julia.
And LC, that is Lily Cool.
Lovely Light also increased their pledge, and they are getting dangerously close to the holy tin light right.
And Emma Taylor, thank you so much for increasing your pledge. We love it.
Madison increased their pledge. Thank you, Madison.
And Faye, thank you, Faye.
Natalia Nalepa increased their pledge. Thank you, Natalia. Thank you, Natalia.
Kermit McFrog also increased. You didn't need to do that, Kermit. You've already given us so much.
Thank you, Kermit. Esty increased their pledge. Thank you, Esty.
Also, Ed, a.k.a. DD Mega Doo Doo.
Yeah, DD Mega Doo Doo.
DD Mega Doo Doo.
DD Mega Doo Doo.
I forgot about that.
DD Mega Doo Doo. Iris Schnapple increased their pledge. Thank you.
Schnapple.
So did Ames. Thank you, Ames. Everyone's getting on this add-on train.
Nerd increased their pledge. Nerd.
Thank you, Nerd. Thank you, Julia Chung. Thank you, Julia.
Thank you, Sabrina. And thank you, Quirlmorts, for both increasing your pledge.
Thank you, Angela Dogani.
Nice name.
I hope that money hasn't gone too far.
Yeah.
Madison increased their pledge. Thank you, Madison.
And thank you, Cassie Chapman. We love it. Thank you.
Nico Marie increased their pledge. Thank you there, Nico.
Also, so did Alex Saha. Thank you, Alex Saha.
Diana Gordon pledge. Thank you, Diana.
Ooh, and Abby Jolin increased. Thank you, Abby.
H increased their pledge. Yes, that is the H. Of the letter fame.
Whoa, that's a big pull. That's famous. Yeah, they're like everywhere.
We got them right from Sesame Street. Yes. Katie Beaver, parentheses Beaver, so maybe Beaver is pronounced Beaver.
I think so.
Thank you, Katie.
Lauren M. increased their pledge. Thank you, Lauren.
Ellie Alexandra, thank you so much. We are happy to have you here.
Shelby Fry pledge. Thank you, Shelby Fry. Welcome to the family.
And thank you, Brianna Johnson. We appreciate it.
Ellen K. increased their pledge, K.
So did Georgia Coxon. Thank you, Georgia.
Haley Spindler increased their pledge. Thank you, Haley. Really happy to have you here.
And then we've got Vivi Pico, who also just increased their pledge. Vivi, thank you so much. Just love you to bits.
Kate pledged. Kate, thank you so much, Kate.
Oh my gosh. Dylan also pledged. Thank you, Dylan. Thank you, thank you.
And we also got an increased pledge from the Grand Duru.
Yeah.
Oh, and I think it got messed up a little bit, but we had a pledge from Dilbo Baggins. Thank you, Dilbo.
Whoa!
Oh, thank Dilbo. Dilbo.
And thank you. Did you say Kate?
I did not.
Thank you, Kate.
Oh,
thank
did
you
I?
For joining.
Yeah, you did.
I blacked out.
Okay, cool.
Kate gets Kate. Thank you, Kate.
Did we do Kara?
We didn't do Kara. Kara increased their pledge. Thank you, Kara.
Where's Kara?
And Lauren S., you might need to refresh. Lauren S. adjusted. Thank you. Grace adjusted. Thank you. Thank you. And then we have a new pledge from Brisson.
Brisson. Thank you. Also an increased pledge from Macy B. Thank you, Macy. And also Rachel Dykes. Thank you,
yes,
Rachel.
Rachel Dykes. And Aaron K., thank you so much. And that is our...
Well, we got one more. And Allie, you're going to freak out because if you thought getting the letter H was a big deal, we got Mars. We got Mars.
Mars?
We got Mars.
We got Mars. Shut up. Thank you for including the pledge. Mars.
Except I just refreshed and we got another... Allie's going to be really excited about this. We got an increased pledge from a mouse.
A mouse. Thank you.
That's I sent them. That's my fam. That's my family. That's
yeah. I didn't want to assume you were related.
I know. I get that all the time, but it's a small little community and we actually all are related. Yeah.
And we also got an increase from Gia. So we're going to stop there for now. Actually, just one more. We're just going to do one more increase played from Faith Like the George Michael Song. That seems like a perfect place to stop in this cool round of shout outs. Faith. Okay.
We are just... shitting our way right up to 190.
Yeah, right to
we're so close.
All the shits we've shat.
We're $829.
All the shits we could shit.
I had that exact same impulse, but I got scared because you're going to get sued for singing songs on the stream.
And it was.
I wasn't saying any songs. I'm saying RuPaul songs.
Oh, okay, yeah. But Aaron's and Flaherty are fine.
She's going to get her. Yeah, I'm sure they're fine.
Okay.
Rue needs every.
I would give a mouse a debit card because I'm terrible with finances, but I don't know. Like, why shouldn't I have an opportunity?
Yeah, but give a mouse a debit card and then what are they going to want next?
Right? Your social security number. But I don't know. A mouse, why shouldn't they have an opportunity?
I agree. Know,
do we have another debater?
We got another little mouse in the waiting room.
I will surprise you. That's one thing my dad usually.
We got another little mouse in the waiting room waiting for some cheese. Time to cheese it up.
This person famously outspoken about mice. Welcome to the stream.
Hi.
Oh my God.
Look at all the mumbling mice on the stream.
Many mumbling mice right there.
Making midnight music in the moonlight.
My team.
I'm here to win debates and eat cheese. And I'm all cheese.
Oh, yeah.
And there is a listeria outbreak.
Yeah. Esther, you know what? I want to catch you up just so you're not like really taken aback. But I came to play really hard and I made sort of some like some, I don't know what you'd call them, political ads to mudslinging, but I want I did not do anything. I have not made anything against you. I just want you to know that.
How could you even?
Exactly. That's that's honestly exactly right. So
Allie just hit Department is here of to attack. Security.
What? Yeah, exactly.
We've got to hit Department of Homeland Department Security. Of Homeland
Security. What? No, I didn't.
Yeah, he actually said that.
Allie,
he
actually, do you want to play? Just to attack the men.
Do you want to play Joey's?
Okay, fine, do it.
I can't, because I feel like this is actually really important because we have
three, because I'm not debating,
three beautiful women on this stream right now, and I really can't do think it's I think women, it might be, I can't it might be important women, that you play this.
I can't support women. I can't support women. Women.
That's so fucked up.
Wow. Oh my god, Joey.
Oh my
and
god.
And are like you're 100% sure they aren't deepfakes?
No, these all really happened. I was there. Oh these
all happened, and that cuts together. Seriously? Yeah.
I forgot I about the Western live stream. Down, so the Western really live stream from last week.
Hear that one.
Oh my god.
Women, women.
I've actually
I can't do that with my voice.
Yeah.
Thank you for whistleblowing because I've been scared. This all was said to me. This was all said to me.
Yeah. I've got my spies. I've got spies everywhere. Yeah. So you can't escape, okay. You know?
Is there a Joey 2?
No, that was it. I thought that one spoke for itself.
Yeah.
That one, think, made the statement.
I mean, I guess the subtitle of Joey 2 after that video would be Pig in the City.
Yeah.
Wow.
And we just went up in dollars. No.
Are the results in? Have we gotten results?
Allie just really took the thumbnail very literally, where it was like us versus the Tin Can Bros. You go, that was just clickbait. I didn't mean that.
I actually don't believe in clickbait. I believe everything I see on the internet is true.
I do too. And I felt so bad for Allie because I'm her partner and I was like, well, I'm not going to be helpful at all. But
it's okay. I am. I got this.
Okay. I am changing the subject now. The results are in from the last debate. So, what is the coolest thing to say on your deathbed? With 6%, the lowest amount was nothing.
Whoa. I'm so sorry.
You know what?
With
y'all can get fucked.
With 19%,
too cool for school.
With 19% of the vote was look behind you.
Oh, damn.
With 20% of the vote, just edging out 19, was see you in another life, brother, which means with 53% of the vote was I hope you find where I buried it. Angela, that's congratulations.
Wow.
Speech.
Incredible.
Speech. Speech. Speech.
Oh boy.
No.
Why are we highlighting Corey? That's so weird. A woman just won an election and a man.
We don't even need to play a clip of Corey. Corey just does it to himself right here live.
Oh, just Kanye me. Thank you. That is a very, I'm honestly very surprised. You may have, your audience may be up for a little bit of chaotic and weirdo fun. Perhaps I knew the audience. I'm surprised and appreciative. Mm. I think everybody's answer was actually really pretty great.
Don't say that.
Listen, kindness wins.
I'm gonna do what we always do, which is Angela's gonna say something. I'm gonna be like, wait, hold on a second. You be being like, suck my, you're good. I did the best answer. It was objectively the funniest, which it was. I deserve this win. The votes were correct and they fell the way that they were supposed to, which is that I came to play and win. And you did. You came to play and win. It was fucking great.
Listen, the fact that Allie has done weeks of research on us, you know, night and day, and Angela rolls up here with this off the cuff and just crushes it. It's pretty cool.
It's a lesson to learn.
Pretty telling. And it is a lesson, yes.
Wow.
Wow.
Thank you.
Let's do another one.
Okay. Another what?
Another debate.
Let's do it!
Oh, side note, Esther. So we don't know. We've just sort of met in this universe, and so I looked up your Instagram and like looked at all your awesome. You're so funny. You're so smart and so cool. I was like, oh my god. Anyway, your comedy is really amazing. Cool.
Camaraderie in the great debate. This is so funny. We could not have been on more opposite tracks.
I was like, women supporting women and women attacking men. That's what this is like. The stream is about.
Oh, I was like, what's What is Esther all about? Anyway, but I was like, you know, get it? Got it? Easy. It's very memorable. You know?
Oh, my God. Thank you.
Okay. And agree.
I also, my brother is trans, and I was like, that is just, you know, it was, I don't know. It's just great. It was, I don't know. Like, it was just.
Aww.
So, yeah.
Thank you for saying that. I'll have to stop you back.
This Yay. Is great. Let's just all compliment each other, except for the brothers.
Listen, we're just here to facilitate, and please remember that the debates are for comedy and entertainment purposes only and may not represent actual opinions of the panelists or Tin Cam Bros.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes. Thank you.
Our compliments are all real. The compliments are all real.
Compliments are real.
All right.
Okay, interesting. Yeah, it's very interesting.
Let's get into our next debate. Okay, wait, who is this gonna be? No, not you. Well, nope. Whoa. Okay, we're done there. Okay, and Brian gets in here. Okay, wait, this needs to be three. How do I make it three?
Give me 1 second. I'll just okay. do it. Okay. We ran out of layouts. So here's
we ran out of layouts.
Here's three.
Perfect. Ooh. Oh, perfect. Oh, but we don't need Brian.
Hi, okay. See you another.
Ooh.
Oh.
No.
Whoa.
Okay. Oh. We did it. Okay. Here we go. We have the next debate, which we are going to dive right into, which is the guiltiest pleasure. Ooh. So first up, thank you, audience. So first up, because, you know, they went in the middle last time, will be Allie.
Cool. Sweet. Okay. This is actually a pretty straightforward answer without any mudslinging. I believe that anything that you derive pleasure from isn't really like a guilty pleasure. You should just enjoy it. But when I think about the things that give me the most joy, that have the least amount of bearing on my actual life, my guiltiest pleasure is being invested and fully informed about a friend's work drama, even though you don't go there. Having full opinions on what people should be doing, who should be fired, knowing years worth of the back and forth, the office dramas, the romances, you know, being mad that certain people didn't get a promotion or that some people in the marketing team got better seats on the flight for the overseas trip, like that kind of stuff. It doesn't matter to me, but they become like my little Sims, and it matter. It while it has no bearing on my life, it is like sort of a life and death thing for me. Thank you. Mm. That is my guiltiest pleasure.
Perfect. Next up, we have Angela. Please share with us your guiltiest pleasure.
I'm gonna use the first few seconds to say, Allie actually does live that because she has been fully invested in every time someone's mean to me at work. So
and those people are all dead now.
And they all said really cool shit before they died.
They did. So,
but the coolest one didn't.
I tried to go with what I think is universal. And I think the guiltiest pleasure that has to apply to everybody is picking your nose. So it's the thing that you were told not to do when you were a kid. Don't pick your nose. It's the thing that every kid makes fun of you for doing. Like, ew, you pick your nose. Ooh, you like him. He picks his nose. You ever like look over at a car and someone's picking their nose, like thinking you can't see them. And you're like, ugh, except that everybody does it because how are you supposed to get the boogers out? Do you all have great boogers that just magically come out every time you blow? Because I don't, mine get stuck. And I've never seen my husband pick his nose, but I know he does it. And when you pick your nose, it just feels so good because boogers are really uncomfortable. And I feel like you derive relief and pleasure from it. It makes you feel bad inside the end.
Very thoughtful.
You've never seen your husband pick his nose?
Well, he is a trumpet player. Do you think he just blows them out when he blows them?
Yeah, maybe they come out.
Rockets them right out.
I hope that is true.
Make them go into his mouth and then go right out the trumpet?
You know what? He does have to clean his horns in the bathtub, so maybe. I can text him.
Wow.
Sounds like a euphemism.
Wow. I like how rustic that answer was. Okay.
Yeah.
And finally, joining the debate, with her triumphant return to the Great Debate stage, we have Esther Falik. Esther, what is your guiltiest pleasure?
Wait, hold on.
Hold on one second.
I could do it tiny. I could do it tiny.
No.
No. No. No. Minimize women. Minimize the women here. That's insane. No.
It's chill. Block me out. Okay. Oh, and that's my time. Okay. So as you all know, I'm not an evangelical Christian. We can all agree on this, right?
That is so true. I do agree with that.
But sometimes they do make some good points. And one of those points is, we shouldn't be having sex. My guiltiest pleasure is sex. Whoa, sex is so gross. What the hell? I have it sometimes and I like it, but I feel guilty about it. It's something that when you do, you should feel extremely bad about yourself. You should be like, I don't deserve to be outside. Because I did something dirty. And then you should wash yourself off for a long time. And then maybe you'll be clean after a while. But I think we can all agree that.
Wow. Wow.
Wow. Okay.
Three strong offerings here.
Really funny. Really good work, everyone.
Beautiful. Beautiful work.
Everybody. Beautiful. Okay, and now we have a 5 minutes of debate round. Yay, have some fun.
Okay. I mean, what can be said about three intelligent, beautiful women?
Good point.
Such a good point.
What can be said about?
Like, Esther, I don't have a words because you hit on my personal trauma. In a way that I'm like, oh right, was I raised repressed? Is that exactly in my brain? I may need to just sit and think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
I'm like, I really like now you went with what your guiltiest pleasure is, and I love that. And it was honest. And
I was gonna say, I think yours, Angela, was so shockingly vulnerably honest, because you said it and I was like, I don't know if I'd be brave enough to say that on that stream. Like,
I wasn't here in the last debate. Are we just supposed to be supporting each other?
No, you could. No, actually, no, I did not take this tack with the other one at all, if you can even believe it.
Well, because I do love both of yours as well.
if I really had to sincerely try to debate this, I would say, when my very pragmatic
you can cry
Jewish, thank you when my very pragmatic Jewish mother sat me down for the sex talk, we didn't talk about anything technical. She basically said this. This is true. This is 100% true. Women can't win in this society. If you have sex, people will say you're a slut. If you don't have sex, people will say you're a prude. Your friends will be mad at you for not having sex if they're having sex. Your friends will be mad at you if you have sex and they're not having sex. There's no way to please anyone. You just need to do it when you want to do it. And when you know you genuinely want it and someone else isn't telling you to do it, that's when the time is right. I was about 12. It freaked me out, but she was so correct.
Very insane.
Okay, go off, Mom.
Go off, Mom.
Go off, Mom.
Thank you. Thank you, my mom. It is why I am the way that I am today and the insane energy I brought to this stream, but you know, that's fine. But I want to say, so for that reason, I don't feel shame, because I feel in control of what I do and when I do it. And I know I'm doing it for me. Thank you.
Intellectually,
actually similar to what my mom said. So thank you, Faith. Yes.
That's how we should all feel. And yet, no, I feel immense shame. And I'm 37. I shouldn't, but I still do. You got in my head. Esther, this is amazing.
I know.
Yeah.
I have this, like, you know, like when your brain goes, wee, wah, woo, wah, you know, like, and you say, yeah, that's exactly what it did. I don't know if I want to, I just don't want to say anything bad about y'all, but I will say, did anybody ever tell you, as an adult, that now it's okay to pick your nose. It is okay. Did anyone ever hear that message? Because
no,
I don't think anybody ever eventually tells you that it's okay. And it is, because how do you get the boogers? You have to. You can blow and blow and blow.
Yeah.
That's a good point. That's a good point. But let me say, I had an ex that she, when she was like
okay, I have to tell you, like, I'm human. Like, yes, I'm human just like you. And I was like, why? She was like, you want to know the truth? I pick my nose and I love picking my nose. And I was like, honestly, I was like, get something better than that.
But it does mean that it hung over them to such a degree that it felt like this confession.
Is so, yes, you're so, if you catch someone, like if one of your friends picks their nose, like it's like, that is something that you do alone. Like, what are you doing? Which is, it's very similar to some of the shame that is instilled in us around sex.
You're so right, actually. You are actually so right.
Dang it.
And I do love, like, people's work drama. And I think that there is, I gotta be real. If it's what's the guiltiest pleasure, I think that's a pleasure that we all can enjoy communally. There's almost a safety in that.
It's also truly like the cultural definition of a guilty pleasure is like, you know, like, oh, my guilty pleasure is yacht rock. My guilty pleasure is trash TV. One of, like, it truly is, like, if you think about the pure definition of the word, indeed it is.
It is the thing that fuels me while having no real bearing on my life. And I also need other people to do it for me, which kind of feels guilty, where it's like, I can't do my own work drama. I need someone else to give me the goods. Yeah. Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Yeah, and usually that labor goes to a woman.
Yeah.
Wow.
The poll is up in the chat.
Honestly, what a fascinating conversation about just the context of our society and what, you know, why we feel guilty about things. Yeah. You know?
Also, like, you know, thank you to the chat for giving big ups to my mom.
Yeah.
Yeah. And also, happy International Women's History Month starting tomorrow, everyone.
Yeah. Wow. And you know what? It would have been May if it wasn't a leap year, which is sexist.
Do we have a clip of Corey or something we want to play?
I actually do have a clip of Corey. I don't know what we're doing, but is Corey debating in the next one or something? When do we want to do that?
No, it's just you three again. We're not debating again.
We're done. We yield the floor to the women.
Aw, Brian, that's really, Corey, that's really
Brian.
But don't worry, at $190,000, we'll be back. Just under $500, and we'll be back to roll up this conversation.
You can get more men.
I mean, we can play Corey's whenever you're ready, really.
Let's do it. Let's figure, you know, that was such a nice moment. Let's make it not nice.
Can't support women. I can't support women.
Wait. Okay. Oh, sorry. That was the wrong one.
Corey's sewing chaos.
Wow, that was like the director's cut.
Sorry, I got confused because in the studio, I didn't realize that any media I've added to the studio is just has my name on it. So there are multiple. This clip is also labeled Corey.
After the break, we're going to interview Eric.
I didn't do this.
Who climbed the highest mountain in the world, Mount Everest. But he's gay. I mean, he's gay. Excuse me. He's blind. So we'll hear about that.
Okay, let's take a look at the 6 o'clock.
So much.
Actually, it is labeled Corey in my studio. That wasn't a
joke.
I do
love that.
Here's the. Oh no! I saw the title.
I don't think I say it enough, but queer stuff is terrible.
Wow! It actually was like. That was like edited. Way more seamless than those other ones.
Because the thing is, I said most of that.
Like, you said that, which is so you wild. Said that.
Oh my god!
I don't think I say it enough, but queer stuff is terrible.
Yeah.
Oh my god!
And after many years of trying to bring quality queer material to the stage,
oh my god!
I don't think I say it enough, but queer stuff is terrible.
If you can vote for somebody like that, I don't know what that says about you.
I say it enough, but queer stuff is terrible.
No, stop. Oh, wow, okay. We're done with that.
Like, physically can't stop playing it now.
Yeah.
I'm just staying silent because I, like, low-key agree.
Do you want to, like, were you there for the content? Were you there for the rest of the context of that quote?
No.
Because I am saying that.
Yeah, you were kind of saying that.
Because I was like, oh, why is it when I want to watch like something gay, my choices are either something that's like horrifically sad or like terrible.
Yeah.
Yeah. Those are the only options. Like depressing or terrible.
It's like a Tubi movie or milk.
Tubi movie or milk. Hey, you want a Netflix and Tubi movie or milk?
Wow. Wait, that went away too fast. I'm too stupid to read that fast. Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Wow.
The T in TCB stands for terrorism.
I can put mine in context too.
Yeah.
Yes. Soon.
Okay, that's really interesting. I'll be really interested to see that actually.
Okay. Awful.
As the son of a mother, a husband to a wife. I love women.
That sounds like a sign in a Bed Bath and Beyond.
Yeah.
Hello.
I do want to say that debate was so you're both such smart and interesting women.
That's how I feel about you. So you guys, honestly, like both of you are like some of my very favorite people in the whole world. It's truly some of the people I find that I like laugh the hardest with. I think you're all wonderful. This doesn't go for the boys.
These clips that are real and not fake that Allie has brought. Mm-hmm. That's exactly what it's like to write with her. She is just hilarious, constant. And you're like, yeah, that's exactly, it's a great idea.
It's nice. This is so nice. I love
this. Nice. And you know, I don't know, it seems perhaps that nice is not making the dollar amount go up as much.
Yeah, it's true.
Thank you. Let's stay on topic here.
Esther, have you heard the song of the summer? It dropped. It's February, but it dropped that Angela and Allie wrote. As like a
did you hear this?
No.
Oh, get ready.
Oh, let me cue that up, baby.
Get ready. And speaking of wrestlers, if I was a like a what do we call them now? WWE?
Yeah.
Well, but if I was a WWF wrestler, I'd come out to this song, I think.
Wow, yeah.
My ass is in bio. It's waiting for you to click on link in bio, and perhaps you'll get to see some tits too. You may think I'm a bot, but I'm not.
I'm just hot,
and I got something to show you, my ass. Each day I'm so lonely as I spam my replies. Need friend to you, homie, meaning the masturbate themselves through my thighs. If you're looking to get hard, click this link, I won't steal your credit card. My ass is in bio.
My ass is in bio.
My ass.
All right.
Incredible. Angela, I love your voice.
I know, what a beautiful voice. I feel like the general TCB audience doesn't know like the most fun fact about Angela.
Yeah.
Angela, where's a very famous and iconic place people can hear your voice?
The place that most people have heard my voice is I'm the opening voice in La La Land. So the girl in
Another
the highway.
Day of fun.
That is
hello.
Money just went up.
Yeah. Classic and Hall. What are you doing here? Hello.
That was my first SAG job.
That is really cool.
Yeah. Totally random.
It's not the dancer singing.
It's not. And none of the dancers in that first one are actually singing at all. It's all dubbers.
And the money just keeps rolling in.
Whoa. And spoiler alert, it's not La La Land. It is Moonlight. So.
Yeah.
Sorry, Angela was the voice in Moonlight.
The voice in Moonlight. Angela was the handed them the wrong card.
Yeah.
That's chaos.
Man,
that was chaotic.
We're just spitting distance from 190K. I think at 190K, what should we do?
Maybe we'll, I don't know, do
another debate?
Yeah, I'll say something nice about you if we hit 190.
I mean, we should do another debate because I have to leave in about 20 minutes. I got to leave a little bit early and I want to I want to see these clips.
Yeah.
Live.
Maybe let's do a few. Let's do a few shout outs.
Yeah.
Good call.
Shout outs are great.
We got a few shout outs.
I think, but also we should all apologize. The TCB should apologize at one
for everything.
For everything. I'm sorry. For everything.
No, not yet.
Yeah. We haven't hit 190.
Oh, okay. That was Commissioner Gordon.
I'm not sorry.
Yeah, no. Oh!
Apology is only valid if it's paid for.
Mm. Yes. And it was paid for by Christopher, who made a new pledge. Thank you, Christopher.
That's right. And it was also paid for by an increase from Chaos, the spirit Chaos. Thank you, Chaos.
Ooh, unbelievable. And Ilsa Spears. Thank you, Ilsa Spears. You have speared your way to our hearts.
Okay, when I say Avalee, you say long. Avalee.
Long.
Increase their pledge. Thank you, Avalee.
And thank you, Natalia Nalepa. It's so nice to have you here and adjusting and increasing.
A very generous increase from Madidid, which I think is Maddie did, but I like Madidid. Thank you. Thank you, Maddie.
And Rebecca Goger. Rebecca, just go get him, girl.
Yes. Oh my god, apologize!
Yay!
Oh,
this is a dream, how exciting!
Man, it's like playing a big slot machine. We got an increase from Manya Ponish. Manya Ponish? Thank you,
yes.
And so sorry.
And thank you, Sarah, for increasing. We so appreciate it. We love you.
And thank you for an increase. Thank you and sorry to Inspector Koichi Zenigata.
Thank you. And thank you, Lana Brown. Thank you for increasing.
Thank you and sorry to Edmund, who pledged. Thank you so much, Edmund. And so sorry for all the world's problems.
And Jennifer Johns, thank you so much. Thank you, JJ. And so sorry.
We've got an increased pledge from Deborah Shapiro. Deborah, thank you, and so sorry.
And Alyssa Bloomberg, thank you so much, and so I am so deeply sorry.
Refreshing the screen. Kara Langworthy increased their pledge. Kara, I'll say thank you, and Joey, you say
sorry. Alex Saha, Alex. You know, when I say thank you, Brian says sorry. Thank you.
Thank you. And sorry.
Okay.
Sierra increased her pledge. Sierra, thank you so much.
So sorry. And Ed, a.k.a. the dude. Sorry.
Duty.
Sorry dude? For a duty. And thank you for it and sorry for it.
Thank you. Lana increased her pledge. Thank you, Lana. Sorry.
So sorry. And Hyro Griffin, thank you so much. Probably put us right over the edge and so sorry. We're really, really apologizing. Thank you so much.
As
so
much
sorry.
As we love edging, that is our guilty pleasure as Tin Can Bros. We like even better just hitting the goal.
All righty. And let's do another debate. I want to watch these clips. Now I'm watching these clips.
Great.
No. Wonderful. And now this final debate topic for the day and of the campaign.
Wait. What?
We never finished the last one.
We never did.
Oh, yeah. We didn't announce.
But does it matter?
The last one. It does matter. It does matter.
Sex,
okay.
Sex.
Okay.
Sex,
okay.
Please.
All right.
Christian Wright, please.
So, okay. Out of the poll, with the lowest score at 25%, the guiltiest pleasure at the lowest was someone else's work drop.
Right. The funniest outcome of this is me losing all of me.
Not winning it.
There's nothing funnier than me coming
in right away going, I love
months of research.
Okay, and in second place with 32%, the guiltiest pleasure is sex. Which means at 42, at 42%, the guiltiest pleasure is picking your nose. Speech.
Oh my god, I saw Brian.
Oh no. Oh no, sorry. There we go.
Speech.
I was okay. Well, here you go.
Yeah.
I always wondered if I was the only one who was gross. But you've taught me today that 42% of you are just as gross as I am.
Wow, and an anger.
That makes me feel less alone. Thank you, Tin Can fans.
Wow.
That was really iconic.
Wow.
Really
beautiful.
Oh my god.
Really. Oh my god.
Really beautiful.
I was honestly thinking maybe somebody would say, actually, we don't pick our noses. You're probably one of the only people that actually does.
No. I think everyone does.
Your vulnerability.
And you bring up such a good point about parenting that people say, hey, you can't do this. But no one ever like finishes that in our lives and says like, hey, you know what? Like you have permission. So I think like going around in life and just, you know, empowering people to pick their nose is like a beautiful thing.
And pick your nose. Empower people to pick your nose.
Your nose.
Yeah.
You see Angela, just feel free to get in there.
You can. I had a septoplasty and the nostrils are really even.
I always said that about Angela's nostrils. They're so even.
So even.
I think that it was a medically necessary nose job, but it was a nose job.
How does it feel to know you're actually so good at debating?
Or to nose.
Uncomfortable.
Uncomfortable?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I think it's nice to know. Oh boy, I don't know. Corey and I've had this discussion. We hate compliments. I don't know.
Say thank you.
It feels good. Fine.
Oh, that's great.
Wait, don't puke. Beautiful. Don't puke. It's all good.
My muscles are very tight right now. Okay, we're good.
You're doing great. Wow. It's amazing. You're winning.
Great.
I understand. Wow. It's like now you know you have this power, and you're like, that's our whole responsibility.
I think maybe people just also like saw the fear in my constant expression of fear and like, let's give her a win today.
Hey, it's working for you.
I will say though.
I'm doing it again. Okay. Scott, what are you doing?
I don't know.
Fair and square. Your answers are really good. People are not looking at your expression and voting for a piece of pity. Yeah. Put it in the chat. Say no pity. Say great answer. Say I love that. I do that too.
Like
that.
How many of us are genuine? Like I'm a Midwesterner, and I think there's also like a thing where we were just taught to like hope that people hit you with a car instead of said nice things. I don't know. Like is anybody where are you? Yeah. Like the being raised to be a confident person like is so cool. I love it when I see other people like with this like natural like, you know, that's beautiful. I'm trying to work on it. So
anyway, we're getting some no pities in the chat.
Yeah, no pity in the chat.
I will say though, that is like the most even. I feel like the closest it's been. Like it's been pretty even across the board of the debate.
I was hoping for 33.3 across the board. Wouldn't that have been?
Yeah.
That would be. If you love women, you'll make that happen in this next one.
That's true. Speaking of women, heaven, and men, hell. Joey, tell us about the next category.
The next category is going to be, what is the weirdest depiction of heaven and or hell that you've seen in media? Let's first start with our previous final debater, Esther Fallick. Esther, what have you brought us today?
I brought a clip from the 1997 film Spawn.
Ooh. Mm.
All right. I'll roll the tape.
It's like a 5-minute YouTube clip. Don't watch. Did you
we'll
like
fast forward?
Okay, we'll fast forward. Okay, great. Yeah.
Come on down to my
world. Okay, wait, so
classic portal to hell.
Oh wow, they get pulled up from fireplace. Very Harry Potter coded. Oh wow.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh wow, look at that. Oh wow.
All right, you overgrown gecko.
This very, looks. Oh my
god. It's very hardcore lava, bro.
Oh my god. Should we fast forward? At the end, does that wild clip happen?
Yeah, fast forward like. Yes. This is the crazy part. Yeah.
Okay, also, let's not play too much. Heaven forbid the stream gets taken and shut down.
Sure.
Oh, that's true. That's true. Here, this is.
I'm gonna turn down the volume just so that they can't content ID it as easy. Mm. I don't know if that's a thing. Yeah. And also the horrific screams of Satan
imagine. Look at all these characters.
Is, like, spawns
at all damn chickens.
Oh, yeah.
This is very like Windows 95.
I was going to say, look at that. That's a screensaver if I've ever seen one.
Oh, wow. This was a real movie.
Yeah. People paid money and saw this in a theater.
Unreal.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah. So yeah, there's crazy.
So that's you know, and they're all there, and he shoots their.
And he
their
shoots
asses.
Lasers or something.
He shoots lasers up their asses. Beautiful clip.
Thank you. So yeah, the 90s special effects. You know, we all know about ILM. Later, we got Weta. You know, it was like there was this moment when like practical effects were leaving and computers were coming along. And there was a lot of like hubris when it came to like what was possible with CGI at this time. And everything looked like a PlayStation, like PS2 cutscene or a screensaver. And it just is really bad and gross looking. That being said, there is something comforting about it. There's something very comforting about that lack of texture and everything. And I also anyway, my time is up. It's crazy.
Well, can you believe Steven Spielberg saw that film and said, we gotta make the dinosaur CG?
Wow.
Next up, we have Angela, please describe your depiction of heaven and hell that you've presented.
Okay. Do you have the clip of it or no?
Yeah.
Me too.
Oh, good. Okay. So it's the same one.
All three of us.
Okay. This is the Garden of Earthly Delights, a triptych by Hieronymus Bosch. The left panel is the Garden of Eden. The center panel is like a hedonistic pleasure world, and the right is hell. And it was painted in between 1490 and 1510. And it looks like you can spend your whole life looking at this painting and you would never see all the absolutely batshit insane things that are going on in this painting. And I saw it in Spain in person, and it's kind of a life-changing.
Wow.
I'm getting in to look at it more.
Wow.
So I don't know if I should.
You don't want the copyright claim.
I don't know if I should use my debate.
In public domain?
Should I use my debate time to describe it? Because
Can you call out some key details, maybe?
Yes.
I mean,
So let's, in the center panel, you have things like every tiny detail it's like a Where's Waldo of like putting flowers in people's buttholes. You have people like having different kinds of sexual experiences with birds and strawberries. Mm-hmm. This is like 1490. Mm-hmm. You have like bizarre shapes and fruits and foods that don't exist. You have people like reaching up into other people's buttholes. You have people just doing like all kinds of absolutely bananas. And then hell, you have this looks like a Monty Python meets Dolly meets some bananas. Like, it's insane. So there's like people pooping in people's mouths. There's like people using like half of someone's head as a toilet. Like, it is just like in every little, it's incredible. And this, like, it's so ahead of its time. It's the weirdest thing I've ever seen. It's the most moving piece of art I've ever seen. And it is probably the weirdest piece of art I've ever seen. I hope Paul is like that, though. That's kind of cool.
It's so punk rock. And not a single person, famously, though. Not a single person picking their nose.
No,
that is true.
Not one.
That is true.
Allie, now it is your time. What is the clip you have brought for us.
I brought in a clip from the ostensibly children's movie, All Dogs Go to Heaven.
Let's take a look.
Another classic portal to hell.
Boom. Oh okay, my shot God. Directly into hell. Again, for, I don't know if copyright stuff, once he gets into some lava, maybe skip forward ahead so we can see the end of this clip, which is particularly wild.
Oh my God. Oh, this is hell. Oh, he's being sucked in a tornado.
Yeah. it's saying like no matter how hard you run, you can't escape what is destined for you. And for him, it is hell because an angel who is a whippet told him that because he escaped heaven once, he can never go back to heaven. He can only go to hell. They say this to him explicitly in the film. This is ostensibly for children. Yeah, here he is on this boat trying to climb out of hell. Look at that.
That is really freaky.
I do love
you said
the
skip
like,
to the end.
Yeah, no? Skip. Yeah, you can. I mean, you can kind of see this devil.
Well, we're almost done.
Okay, I still want us look to get shut down.
Oh yeah. Gosh, yeah, I remember this. Oh yeah. God, that's freaky.
Did it make it any less scary knowing going into it that all dogs go to heaven?
No, because because a dog says to him, "You can't come back to heaven." He got one freebie. He died. He goes to heaven. The angel's like, "That's it. We assume all dogs are good." Then he steals that watch, which is his life. And they say, mm-hmm. if you ever die again, you will go to hell because you've been a bad dog. And this is him dreaming about the hell.
Aww.
But that's just a puppy dreaming at him. So he's okay.
But then it ends nice.
It does end nice. I just want to say, you can't see it in that video, but the title of that clip was All Dogs Go to Heaven, Hell Scene, Real Clip, No Added Audio. That means that clip is so fucked up that the person who uploaded it needed to be like, this is actually directly from the movie. I didn't mess with this in any way, shape, or form.
Yeah.
This is exactly as it was presented. I think that's a credit to it that like somebody had to go out of their way to be like, no, for real though, this is actually what was in the movie. So basically beyond the depiction of it there, which I think is very scary legitimately, the other part that is additionally fucked up about it is that they basically are intimating that his fate has been sealed and there is nothing he can do to escape hell, which is why he's having this nightmare about it, because he was told explicitly to his face, if he ever dies again, heaven is not an option. He's done. He's got to go to hell, and he will experience that forever and ever for the rest of his days until the universe has a heat death. I don't know. So yeah, messed up.
As we enter the open debate round, I just want to remind everyone that this is the weirdest depiction of heaven and or hell in media.
And I want to clarify that the weird part for me was that they thought that would fly in a movie for children. Not that it's like specifically bizarre in terms of like, it is a pretty standard depiction of hell, but the fact that they were like, yeah, kids should see this and kids will like it. And then we'll get right back to the film.
Thank you so much, but that is all struck from the record because the time did not start. And your time starts now.
That jury audience that do not factor that. Any of that.
Any of those. That was
I will repeat exactly what I said verbatim.
All right. I actually have to leave
bye, Joey.
Right now, but I love you all and want to can we play one more clip?
Oh yes,
yeah,
time.
Yeah.
We have one
this
more
is
clip.
Hell. Joey leaving. I'm in hell.
This is hell. So we have one more. This is hell. We have just one more clip. Yeah. And this is what I'll go out on.
After the break, we're going to interview Eric Weyenmayer, who climbed the highest mountain in the world, Mount Everest. But he's gay. I mean, he's gay. Excuse me. He's blind. So we'll hear about that coming
up. Okay, as we head to the break, a look at the 6 o'clock.
It was good fun. It was good fun. Lauren is watching over my shoulder, watching what people say about it.
I'm sure they're losing their minds.
Yes.
Take your text.
That was so good. Also, Joey, before you leave.
Yes.
I love all you. I just really
love you so much. This was really funny. I got to show all, I'm going to download those clips and show them to Lauren. She's going to find them to be very funny.
Please don't want you to all think I like think you're hateful or anything.
No, it's really funny. It's really great. Okay. Love you, everyone. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Okay, thank God he's gone. Now I can say what I really feel.
Okay, folks, welcome to heaven. Your time starts now.
Well, I don't have much to say. I think that the painting fucking won.
Okay, can I just say? I think that the painting fucking won.
Yeah.
I mean, like, I didn't want to say it first because, again, I wanted to, I am sort of coming in. I'm trying to pitch myself as the villain of this franchise. Sure, I never get to play a villain. All I ever want to do is be sort of villainous. I was cursed to look like a 12-year-old child. I'll never get to be a bad guy. Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah. So, like,
very Lestat,
I was coming in.
Very Lestat.
Be the villain in a horror movie?
Yeah, true. The orphan. Neat.
Yeah.
Basically, I really wanted to come in hard and I really wanted to win because I love winning. But I cannot deny that the painting was the best that we had to offer here.
Yeah. I'm going to be bitter. I'm bitter about sex. I think we should all feel so guilty about sex. But that, which is why I was so drawn to that painting.
Yeah. It was exactly what the brief asked for, which was the weirdest.
Yeah, it gets weird.
It does get weird.
Yes, give us a full screen.
Like, it's got, there's just, all the animals are not, like, they're all sort of, even in the, like, there's, like, a giraffe, but, like, not really. Also, where the fuck was Hieronymus Bosch looking for a giraffe? Like, where was he seeing a giraffe in Europe in 14?
In their imagination,
just, I guess, perhaps hearsay.
Did you just they them to be?
You bet, because anyone who fucking can paint like this is, I don't know, like
not
another
planet. Also, all the structures are like very like almost like organs. It is sickening. It is a very gross, cool.
But it's also like it makes me cry because it's so incredible that someone, like, it looks a little bit like Dali. Like, someone could be that forward thinking, hundreds of years ahead of their time. Like it was that person. Was it time travel? I don't know. It's so bizarre. Like, you know. But also, I have to say, All Dogs Go to Heaven always makes me cry my whole ass off.
Yeah,
that's why I grabbed Zap, because like that movie, that was like a childhood defining for me. I don't know.
Also, do you remember when they all pull at the piece of pizza?
That would make me so hungry.
Oh, when I think about pizza, I think about the pizza in that movie.
The
all the little puppies pulling the cheese.
It scratched my hunger brain when I was a kid. Like, I want to eat that pizza. Why is that? That every time I eat a piece of pizza, that is the pizza I'm trying to recreate. The cartoon.
Me too.
Pizza
from all I feel that.
So that's how I feel about like when they dip the crackers in the milk in the Aristocats.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is great. I love that we're not debating. We're just sort of all agreeing on fun things. This is really fun.
There could be no better final debate than just like how Allie just ripped us all, and then it's just like a big old love fest.
Let's go around and see what we love about each other.
Okay,
that's fun. Yeah. Crazy. Although, Angela, is this your hell? Just being like, I need to sit here and accept some nice compliments?
A little bit. But you know, it is nice to be loved. It's both.
Yeah.
No, Brian, we're not invited to this.
No, Brian, get the hell out of here.
I want to try
to get compliments.
For Angela, this is a compliment, but it's also true, which I just think that people should know. So, like, I walked around my house and improvised some lyrics for Ass and Bio for a while and then kind of like typed some stuff out. And then I sat down with Angela for, I would say, a grand total of 17 minutes before that tune was done, finished.
Too long.
Wow.
I told you not
like,
to.
Like, Angela literally went behind. I was like, I kind of am picturing it like as like a, I was like, I think it'd be funny for it to be sort of like, I feel like the lyrics seem like it should be like fun dance club slut pop, but like, I think it'd be so funny for it to be like a plaintive country love song. Angela literally goes, reaches behind her on the wall, takes a guitar off the wall, and it's like this. The song is like, that's it. Like, she sang it through once, and I was like, yeah, like that. That would be, if you just want to like turn your mic on, that would be great. Like, that's a massive talent. I like don't understand how that is possible. So how about that for a compliment?
How about that for a compliment?
It makes me feel loved and fulfilled. But your lyrics are so easy. When you write a lyric, and I know you say it's insane to me, literally insane that you say you're not a lyricist, because you are so good at it. When I see what you write, I hear it immediately. And I think that that's not always true. You know, and like it's I'm just like, this is what that is. Yeah. And you have great musical ideas too. It's because like, you know, truly a collaboration can only be what it is. It's the beautiful song babies that we make together. It's just like, cause you're great to write.
Thank you. You know, okay. And we've only got, wait, if you want the timer run out before Esther, about Esther,
working with you, so Esther Texas. Is a joy.
Okay. Time's out. I got to get big again. Oh, okay. So sorry.
You know. Uh-oh, silencing women.
Oh, so we put it out in the chat.
Not again.
We put it out in the chat. The question was, hold on, did Angela do a clean sweep? 22% of the chat said yes. 77% of the chat said very yes.
Yeah.
Give us
that.
It's never been done before. It's never My been done God. Before.
Really? I did watch these. This is not something that happens.
That's really unexpected. I will... I... Thank you. I'm going to use my time to say that one of my favorite things to do is when... So you get to... I get to essentially meet all these cool fans and like basically mooch off of my friends' hard work by getting to connect with all of the people that love what they make. So these... misogynistic, domestic terrorist, and homophobic men that you love so much. they are wonderful people. I mean, you're even Brian, but I it is so cool to watch like behind the scenes that someone who is your friend be so smart and so good at what they do. Like anytime Corey has an idea, like you don't even know like how like Corey, like graphic design, writing, singing, just hilarious comedy, like it just like Corey's brain, Joey's brain, like just they are great people, and it is amazing to be friends with people that are so smart and talented, and they're also just like really lovely human beings to be around. And I feel like sometimes, I don't know, like I hope that you feel good about being supporters of guys that are really good guys. Yeah, exactly.
Wow. on a note that really completes this full story, Angela, that's so nice of you to say. Corey and Brian, I have sent a box of live locusts to your house. So, cool. You know, yeah. We're just bringing it right back to the beginning.
Bouncing the universe.
Yeah, exactly.
Beautiful. Yeah. So
when we did, what did we do? Oh, when we did that score, I sat and I went, I was talking to my husband. I was just like, I'm so fulfilled right now. Like I love getting to do this with you guys. I love getting to make things with you guys. I love that you, the three of you, hired a female songwriting team.
All right, let's. Well, hold on. We don't have to give them off. Go on.
Yeah.
I was just like, this is great. So I don't know. I just, I don't know.
Yeah. And I mean, we're so close to funding this thing, which is making me so excited that it's all becoming more of a reality. So yeah, also like to be going to New York later this year too, and working with Esther again, and like doing more of this could be on Broadway stuff.
Can't wait.
Is gonna be huge. I can't wait. And actually, since we've been on this stream, the time has dropped down, and we just have 48 hours, Oof. Just 2 days Woo! To go Woo! To hit our goal. So as we said at the beginning, this is the last debate stream until hopefully the real debate that's coming in the next couple months, live in Los Angeles. But this Saturday we're gonna be streaming for 10 hours. So, you know, the three of you are obviously invited to swing by in person or digitally.
And save us from ourselves.
And save us from our slow descent into CG hell.
Should I make sure I come loaded with some more ammunition or what?
Hell yes.
It was awesome. It was so funny, Allie.
That's about the top level of my editing abilities. I can't really do any more than that. So
that's all you need to change the world.
So Gandhi said that.
All you need is iMovie and a dream.
Yeah.
Have you seen Gandhi's videos?
Yeah. He said some stuff about you, Brian.
Yeah. But I'm talking about the editing. The editing is quite good.
Oh, how he hires that out, though. He doesn't even edit his own videos.
Oh, so close. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh.
This has been so exciting. I was like really secretly hoping in my heart that we'd be here for 190 because it's just like such it's so exciting. It's so close. I'm just it's so exciting. It's
so close. I can't do math, but I think that means 95% funded.
Yeah.
That's so awesome.
It does, and wow. There's no way to check if that's right.
There's no possible way to check.
Listen, Brian. Men are always taught to not speak highly of themselves. Break that pattern. You can do math.
Thank you.
Esther, how did you meet the 10 Can?
I went to the University of Michigan.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We unfortunately, Angela, we all went to the University of Michigan. Yeah.
So sorry.
So sorry.
Hail
to the that was funny last week when we were on the stream with Giovanni and she like learned that. She was like, wait, she didn't realize that like
it's secret.
And honestly, that was a huge compliment.
Yeah. That is actually true. I was hanging out with some people I was meeting some new people at a bar last week and they went, wait, you went to Michigan, but you didn't bring it up during the conversation at all. And I was like,
I try to hide the fact that I went to Michigan, but then as soon as I start singing,
I know you just communicate text so well.
That sonic signature in your voice has that, you know, that Brent Wagner, that Mark Madonna.
Exactly.
I think it's so lovely. I miss my jazz grad school friends so much. I think it's really awesome that y'all have been making stuff together.
Yeah, it certainly was worth $40,000 a year to meet all these lovely people and make friendships for life.
I was just thinking about Brian and I took the same tap class with the same.
Oh, we got stories.
Horrible tap teacher, but we were doing ragtime in the spring of our sophomore year. I feel
It was your sophomore year, our junior.
Oh, I thought Brian was my age. Okay, never mind. Either way, we were doing ragtime, and I don't feel like we planned this, but I feel like we rode the same energy length. Do you remember that we convinced her that there was a big tap number in ragtime for the Jews coming off the boat at Ellis Island?
Yeah. She was so prankable because she was just like mildly racist and like a little mean. And so it's just like, I don't give a shit about just like steering, like gaslighting this person.
This old woman.
That's hilarious.
Who like came up tapping with like Gregory Hines. Like, I don't know. Like her point of reference was very old school, but yeah, we totally got her. You know, like they come off the boat into America.
We were like, and again, thank you so much for teaching us this because we will be auditioning so soon. And you know, there's a big tap number in ragtime.
Yeah, it's a shim sham.
That's insane, and I love that so much. That's God. Yeah. Oh, that's it's odd that they would. I don't know.
How she got the job is a mystery. Do we want one last musical mashup title?
Oh, sure. Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Okay, ready?
Yeah.
It's 1920s Manhattan, and a young girl comes to take the jazz scene by storm by going to Memphis where Elvis Presley and three other guys, famous musicians ostensibly, are having the jam session of the century.
Thoroughly modern Million Dollar Quartet.
That's good.
Wow.
That is good. Oh, it was on the tip of my tongue. Damn it. That's awesome.
I got that one this morning and I was like, yes.
yes. Should we do a final round of shout outs?
You bet.
Yeah.
You bet. Thank you to everyone who has backed or pledged on the stream.
How many new backers did you get?
While we've been here? Mm-hmm. I don't know.
100.
There's no way to tell.
That's 100, Joey's maybe. 100,000, yeah. Maybe. Yeah.
Joey's the math magician here.
But I can tell you this. I know to be true.
We did get
an increased pledge from Jackalope.
A mythical animal, but it's real to us.
That's right.
We also had another increase from Polly Harrison. Thank you, Polly, and we're sorry.
We're so sorry, Polly. An incretion and a secretion from Louis Leclasio. Thank you for your increase. We appreciate you and so sorry.
Emily BC increased their pledge. BC, they're awesome. I'm so sorry.
We've got an increased pledge from Joe Rowe, which I believe is a mashup at the beginning of Joey's first name and my last name. Joe Rowe increased their pledge. Thank you, Joe Rowe. So sorry.
Kelsey Hubbard increased their pledge, and I'm so sorry.
Now, this is one person I can't apologize to. An increased pledge from Harley Campbell. Thank you, but I will not apologize.
Whoa, stand your ground.
You should not apologize to a soup heir.
No.
Go off.
Wow. Go silence. Rachel Dykes. I'm really sorry. But thank you.
Thank you. Ebony Pledge. Thanks so much, Ebony. Also, huge thank you to Ed the Dude Abides for another increase in your pledge. We really appreciate it, and we are so sorry on behalf of all men everywhere.
Tamara O'Rourke increased their pledge despite everything we've done. And for that, I am sorry.
Despite. We also have a new pledge from Rory Barker. Thank you, Rory. Thank you so much. Welcome. Welcome to the fold. It's great here. It's great. Bless you. Bless you and bless everyone who turned out today to watch this stream. And bless our guests. And bless everyone who's been along for the last 31 days, 30 days. I don't know how many days we're into this thing.
I don't know.
But
how many days does February have? 47?
Yeah. 47. Yeah.
It's a leap year, so it actually has 64.
Yeah, that's what it's felt like.
And then just a couple of quick increased pledges that just like needled their way in there. And no, these are not from a mouse. So sorry. These are from Christina Joy. Thank you, Christina. Play the music. Love it. Thank you, Christina. So sorry. Sorry, Christina. And also Kara Langworthy, who is always worthy of a shout out. Oh, yeah. Thank you.
We're
for
not
your
worthy.
Increase. We so appreciate it. We are not worthy. We're not worthy. I think that's it.
I am enjoying this, what's it called? Garage Band loop.
Right. Yeah, it's pretty good. And reminder that like you can still bet we've got like all the cool rewards and we've got like all the fun add-ons now too, including, you know, these fun shirts featuring everyone's favorite TCB mascot that you've known and loved for years.
Who has body hair on the inside.
And the bottom. We got poster, we got magnets, we got hats, we got stickers up the wazoo. And of course our meme buttons. But yeah, so go check those out and beautiful. Join us for our final stream on Saturday when we're gonna stream for 10 hours to celebrate 10 years and lose our fucking minds.
Yeah.
Oh, so I like how the 416 and the 416. I like this like symmetry, but my
a holy number.
It keeps happening, which is like just you know, truth that magic is real. It's just like a sign from the universe that we should be creating comedy in this dark, dark world.
And you are also the chosen true prophets of comedy. All religions.
Yes.
Yeah.
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 Yeah,
I was an agnostic before I knew you, and now
that a lot of people say that to us.
Yeah, I'm a convert,
and they should.
Should we end with a prayer?
Yeah,
I think a one-word prayer would be nice. And then, check out Instagram for all the releases we have coming up, and then see you Saturday for the 10-hour stream. Ooh. 10 Ooh. Hours. Yes.
But yeah. Allie, do you want? We can just go around the circle, like.
We just give one at a time.
Yeah, one word at a time.
Like one word of the prayer at a time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, ready? I'll start.
Yeah.
Soup
exists.
Sorry.
That.
We.
Eight.
Most.
Of
it,
bitch.
Play the clip. Play the clip.
Soup exists. Sorry that we ate most of it, bitch.
Amen. Well,
amen.
TC be with you.
And also with you.
And with all and of you. Yeah.
On that prayer, we end, like we do every broadcast, with the sacred text. Oh no, it's gone. Never mind.
Okay.
Well,
play the new one. Play the new sacred text.
Wait, no.
Say it enough.
No, it's not that. Holy fuck. No.
Wow. Yes, the new sacred text. No. You heard it directly from Corey's mouth. No, that's not it. You heard it. This is the new one.
I got it.
After the break, we're going to interview Eric Weinmayer, who climbed the highest mountain in the world, Mount Everest. But he's gay. I mean, he's gay. Excuse me, he's blind.
Okay, as we head to the break, a look at the 6 o'clock.
Wow, if this doesn't go viral, what even is the injury?
What is it?
Oh, okay, God. Bye.
Oh, there goes the money. Good, okay.
So trust us, we're not fishing for the dough to fund our vision. The provisions we envision have long been preordained. Just as we foresaw it, you reached into your wallet and you gave. Yeah, you gave. Your cash well must manifest the grandest end result. Legally, we have to say that this is not a cult. Surely not a cult. And soon the whole wide world will be enlightened.
I mean, he's gay. Excuse me. He's blind.